In this lecture, we're going to talk about an introduction to dizziness. Before we dive into the specific causes of dizziness, it's important to have some way of thinking about how to approach these patients. So let's start with a case. This is a 34-year-old woman who presents to clinic urgently for evaluation of dizziness. The patient reports that she awoke this morning and suddenly felt very dizzy while sitting up in the bed. She was unable to stand and walk due to severe dizziness. Her son escorted her downstairs where they telephoned. In the office, the patient is lying on the exam table, uncomfortable and still. She says that her dizziness feels like the room is spinning. Her eyes are closed. She is freely able to report the history from this morning without confusion, aphasia, or dysarthria. She was able to walk into the clinic and denies any problems with weakness, numbness, or tingling. She has a history of borderline hypertension, which she is managing with diet and lifestyle at this time. She is on a multivitamin only. She has no allergies and denies personal or family history of symptoms, which prompted her presentation. So how would you categorize this patient's dizziness? Well, let's start with the case. What are the key features that we look at in patients who are presenting with dizziness? The first is the timeline of onset. This is critical. It helps us to categorize the type of problem we're going to focus on. And here, this patient presented suddenly with acute onset of symptoms. Not a chronic onset, which would point us in a certain direction, but acute onset of her symptoms, and that will be important when we're evaluating this patient. The second feature are provocating factors or provoking signs. Here, this patient's dizziness was provoked when she was sitting up in the bed or potentially turning her head. And those provoking factors are important for driving us towards certain diagnostic possibilities. The last is the patient's description. When we're evaluating dizziness, we're putting the history and the physical exam together, but the history is really important for beginning our search for what the cause of this dizziness is. And here, this patient describes the room as spinning, and that will be important for labeling this problem, for categorizing her symptom, and ultimately arriving at the diagnosis. So how would you categorize this patient's dizziness? Is it vertigo, disequilibrium, syncope, or non-specific dizziness? Well, the clinical description doesn't sound like disequilibrium. Disequilibrium is imbalance or incoordinations, problems with ataxia or dysmetria on exam, cerebellar findings we see on exam, and none of those are reported or found or described in this patient. So this is an inconsistent presentation for disequilibrium. The patient's description is also inconsistent with syncope. Syncope or presyncope is a feeling of fainting or near fainting, typically when patients stand up in the situation of orthostatic presyncope or syncope, and there's no indication of cardiac dysrhythmias, which would tip us off to a cardiac concern that would precipitate a syncopal event. Non-specific dizziness is a diagnosis of exclusion, and this patient's presentation is really consistent with vertigo. So here, the correct answer, the categorization of this patient's problem, is vertigo. The patient describes room spinning, provoked with head turning or sitting up in bed, and those are common descriptions for patients who are suffering from vertigo.